The FVC, the Family Vocations Community, or for many years known as the Family Vocations Crusade, started its life in 1959 in Drummondine as a sponsoring movement of the Society of African Missions. Last year, in 2019, it celebrated its 60th anniversary. Its original purpose was to assist the Irish SMA in its mission of training and preparing priests to work as missionaries in Africa. And it did this by raising funds to cover the costs of their training in Ireland. The SMA began training their seminarians in Drummondine in 1926. By 1959, over 70 young men were pursuing their studies there. The superior, Father John Joe Conlon, was forever seeking ways to finance the running of the seminary. And with the help of some friends of the SMA, the idea of a sponsoring movement emerged. At that time, it was estimated that it cost £100 per year to maintain a student in the seminary. If a group of people decided to sponsor a student for 1 year by contributing £100, it would go a long way towards the running costs of the seminary. If the group agreed to pledge this amount for 7 years, it would contribute to the education and training of a missionary student throughout his course of studies. It was a good idea, and soon groups of 10 to 20 people were formed who agreed to make this commitment. The first group to be formed was headed by Tommy McKenna, a businessman from Belfast. Tommy and members of his group became familiar faces around Drummondine, and as friendships and contacts developed, more and more people became interested, and the movement grew. In 1966, the sponsoring movement was launched in Cork and subsequently in Dublin. By 1969, the sponsoring movement was well and truly an all-Ireland affair. With so many families involved, there was the potential for vocations to the missionary priesthood from within the movement itself. It was at this point that the name was changed to the Family Vocations Crusade. And its three essential elements were: 1, daily prayer for the missionary work of the SMA; 2, support for training SMA missionaries; 3, the potential for vocations. As the FVC continued to expand, directors were appointed to organize it in each of the four provinces and in Dublin. When Irish vocations to the SMA began to decline in the 1990s, a new venture within the SMA gave a new impetus to the FVC. This was the training of a new generation of SMA missionaries from India, Philippines, Poland, and many African countries. This new direction broadened the vision of our sponsors to reach out to the wider world of mission. Since 1992, more than 370 SMA priests, nearly all from outside Ireland, have been ordained, and to a considerable extent have been sponsored by the FVC. Today, the contributions of FVC members are supporting the education and training of our missionaries in 15 African countries, as well as India, Philippines, and Poland. From the beginning, the FVC was founded by and relies on lay people. Having such an army of co-workers helping the SMA to fulfill its mission is a real sign that the whole church is missionary, and that all our supporters are engaged in our missionary work. To reflect this participation, we changed the name from Family Vocations Crusade to the Family Vocations Community. Because of the FVC, the Society of African Missions is today a household name in thousands of homes throughout Ireland. Due to the present coronavirus restrictions, we cannot gather together as we usually do at this time of the year. but we are very much together in spirit. We are delighted that you can join us here in the SMA Parish Church in Wilton, Cork, this evening for this special FEC celebration and Mass. May the Lord continue to bless us all. Very warm welcome to you all to our SMA Parish Church here in Wilton. We welcome our family vocations community members who are tuned in to this special Mass from around Ireland. Some of our SMA fathers in Africa are also tuned in and in nursing homes in different places, and I know there are people from different parts of the world who are with us now. A welcome to you all. A welcome also just a few of our head sponsors, only a very few, and some members from around Cork City and County who are here with us today. You are welcome. A Cade Milifalchi to each and every one of you. FEC groups that began in 2012 and some in our 2013 have completed another 8-year term, and we thank you. This year, we are very happy to have ordained 28 new SMA priests. They come from various countries in Africa, the Philippines, India, Spain, and one from Slovakia. We also have ordained 18 deacons this year. Special thanks to Father Michael O'Leary, the parish priest here in Wilton, for accommodating us, for Anne in the parish center, for her tremendous help, and our staff members in Black Rock Road, Mairead, Linda, and Patricia, and also for our production team today, Jerry and Paul. A very big thank you to all. I want to introduce our concelebrants. Over here on the left, we have Father Dan McCauley. He's the FEC director for Ulster. And beside him, Father Frank McGrath is the FEC director for the West of Ireland. Then we have Paul Monaghan. He's the FEC director for Leinster and Dublin. And representing our FEC director, who is yet to be appointed, from Munster is Father D.J. Ryan. And the former FEC director from Munster, Father Ignatius Malwa, we will be hearing from him at the end of our service today. And we welcome Father Martin Kavanagh, who will be our preacher today. Just a word to everybody who are online watching us, and even those here. For the next hour, we're going to be in the presence of God. I would ask everybody for a few moments just to close their eyes. Let all of us close our eyes and recognize wherever we are. We could be sitting in our kitchen, our dining room, our living room. Wherever we are at this moment, we are in the presence of God. When Moses met the presence of God at the burning bush, God said to him, "Moses, take off your shoes. The place you are standing is holy ground. Brother, sister, your kitchen floor, wherever you are, your living room, your bedroom, wherever you are now, is holy ground." Let us be aware of God's presence during the next hour. This is holy ground. We're standing on holy ground. For the Lord is present, and where God is holy. This is holy ground. We're standing on holy ground. For the Lord is present, and where God is holy. We begin our celebration in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. As we gather in God's presence to celebrate the sacred mysteries, we recognize our sinfulness as we call to mind our sins. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, by whom we are redeemed and receive adoption, look graciously upon your beloved sons and daughters, that those who believe in Christ may receive true freedom and an everlasting inheritance, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. We listen now to the Word of God.
A reading from the prophet Jeremiah. The word of God came to me, saying, "Before I formed you in the womb, I knew you. Before you came to birth, I consecrated you. I appointed you as prophet to the nations." I then said, "Lord, you see, I do not know how to speak. I am only a child. But God replied, do not say, I am only a child. For you must go to all to whom I send you and say whatever I command you. Do not be afraid of confronting them, for I am with you to support you. Then God stretched out his hand and touched my mouth. And God said to me, there, I have put my words into your mouth. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah. My people will know my name. Therefore they will know on that day that I am he who speaks. Here I am. How lovely on the mountains are the feet of him who brings good news, who announces peace, and brings good news of happiness, who announces salvation and says to Zion, your God reigns. Listen, your watchmen lift up their voices, they shout joyfully together, for they will see with their own eyes when the Lord restores Zion. Break forth, shout joyfully together, you waste places of Jerusalem. For the Lord has comforted his people, he has redeemed Jerusalem. The Lord has bared his holy arm in the sight of all the nations, that all the ends of the earth may see the salvation of our God. The word of the Lord.
Please stand to proclaim the gospel.
Shine, alleluia. Shine, alleluia. Shine, alleluia. Shine, alleluia. Shine, alleluia. God is love, and as long as we love one another, God will
My brothers and sisters, the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
After the Sabbath and towards dawn on the first day of the week, Mary of Magdala and the other Mary went to visit the tomb. And suddenly there was a violent earthquake, for an angel of the Lord, descending from heaven, came and rolled away the stone and sat on it. And the angel said to the women, "There is no need for you to be afraid. You are looking for Jesus who was crucified. He is not here, for he has risen as he said he would. Come and see the place where he lay. Then go quickly and tell his disciples. He has risen from the dead, and now he is going ahead of you to Galilee. That is where you will see him." Filled with awe and great joy, the women came quickly away from the tomb and ran to tell his disciples. And suddenly, coming to meet them was Jesus. "Greetings," he said. And the women came up to him, and clasping his feet, they did him homage. Then Jesus said to them, "Do not be afraid. Go and tell my brothers that they must leave for Galilee. There they will see me." The 11 disciples set out for Galilee, to the mountain where Jesus had arranged to meet them. When they saw him, they fell down before him, though some hesitated. Jesus came up and spoke to them. He said, "All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Go therefore, make disciples of all nations. Baptize them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. And teach them to observe all the commands I gave you. And look, I am with you always, yes, to the end of time." And this is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Thank you. Thank you, Almighty God, for our 28 new SMA priests ordained this year. And thank you to those 28 young men and their families and their formators who helped them to respond to the call that we read about in the first reading from Jeremiah. "Before I formed you in the womb, I knew you. Before you came to birth, I consecrated you." So these young men were able to respond to that call. So thank you for that. And most of all, thank you to you gathered here in this church in St. Joseph's in Wilton today, and all of you, our sponsors and supporters, joining us through the webcam. You, our SMA sponsors, members of the Family Vocations community, are the reason we are here this afternoon, because without your support, without your prayers, but also, most especially, without your financial help, these young men and the 350 others who are in training with our society at the moment in many parts of Africa, in India, in Philippines, in Poland, these young men would not have been ordained. So your support is incalculable, but it's also essential. So thank you for that. These 28 young men that we ordained this year, 22 of them came from 8 African countries: Benin Republic, Congo, Ghana, Ivory Coast, Liberia, Nigeria, Togo, and Zambia. And then the other 6, 2 of them were from India, and because of COVID, they trained in the Ivory Coast, but because of COVID, they couldn't return home to be ordained in their home parishes with their families. So they were ordained priests in the Ivory Coast a few weeks ago. So especially mindful of them, because Ordination Day is a great day for family and village. But for those 2 young men, it was among the place where they will go as missionaries. And the others came from one from the Philippines, from Spain, the United States, and the first one from Slovakia, first SMA from Slovakia. So please God, there'll be many more from Slovakia to follow him. Since we started ordaining priests from these parts of the world, we've ordained over 400 priests from 13 of the 16 African countries that the SMA works in. Not bad. As well as those from India, the Philippines, and Poland. And of course, you all know, people have stopped saying to us now, oh, have you any students in Ireland? Because it's been so long since we had them, we have forgotten that we had them nearly. But as our numbers have gone, and all throughout Europe nearly, except for Poland and Italy and Spain, as our numbers have declined, we have seen a huge growth in priests, seminarians from other parts of the world. So the Lord is still calling. You know, I'm sure many of you join us in praying the prayer for vocations every day as part of your membership of the FEC. The Lord is still calling, but some are not responding, there's no doubt about that. But many who are responding are in these new parts of our society. So thank God that we still have generous young men who respond to the call. And these young men will, as the gospel reminds us, go out to the whole world and preach the good news, to baptize, to tell people of God's love for them. And they'll do such things as helping to build clinics, schools, maybe providing clean water in villages. But mission has changed in the last 40 or 50 years. These things that many of these older men here among us, behind me, did, well, other than Father Paul, he's younger than me, but the rest of all far older. But the work of mission in the past was about building churches and clinics and schools and stuff like that. But today the work of mission is not just in Africa or South America, it's also here in Ireland. The work of mission is about, as Pope Francis reminds us, about the care for our creation, about welcoming the stranger, about looking after migrants, and so many other things. So these young men who will go out on mission today will be involved in many other things as well. And here in Ireland, we in the SMA will continue our missionary work in Africa, as well as here at home, in new ways. And you'll find out lots of things about what we're doing now on our website. So you already know how to gather it because you're watching it on the webcam. You can find out the different ways that lay people are getting involved in the work of mission. And we invite you to join us, to get involved in the care of creation, in parish initiatives, in our thumbprint campaign and things like that. But these young men, along with the SMAs they will join in many parts of Africa, are, as we read there in the second reading, how lovely on the mountains are the feet of those who bring good news. They bring the good news of God's love. Because, as the gospel reminds us, despite COVID, despite the difficulties of the world today, despite the many problems, God is with his church. God is with us. And God will not be overcome. God's will be done. We can help him or we can hinder. But thankfully, you, our sponsors and supporters, are helping to make God's will done on earth as it is in heaven. And in particular, as members of the Family Vocations community, you're helping many young men to be ordained to go out and tell others of this love. Because many of our seminarians come from the very poorest of families. They couldn't afford school fees or seminary fees and things like that. So it is through our sponsorship, your sponsorship, that we are able to welcome these numbers, these great numbers of young men. We turn away many because there isn't enough money for everything, but nor are there enough people to train them. So, you know, we get more than we can take. But thank God for those who come and those who are ordained. And as Father Pat mentioned at the beginning of Mass, you're coming now to the end of another 8-year cycle. In fact, the FVC is 60 years old last year. And last year I met one particular lady in Drumantine who had been with us from just after the first few years. And Patricia was telling me that there's one lady here in the south, in Munster, and she said, you know, I'm nearly 90, and I suppose I won't be around in 8 years' time, but I'll start again anyway. So thank God for that. And as I say in Irish to that lady, I can't remember her name now, Bafekatu an Caid, may you see the hundred. But thank you for your support, and please, you know what I'm going to say, don't you? What am I going to say? Start again, if you can, please. And, you know, you can contact the offices, contact your directors here, and they will help you to see how you might start again or continue in a new way. And as you know, the coronavirus has not just affected how we ordained our priests this year, particularly those two lads from India, but has also limited the work of our directors here behind me, Father Dan, Father Frank, Father Paul, and up to recently Father Tom Curtin, who was in charge of Dublin until Paul was asked to take on that responsibility, and also Father Dennis Ryan as well, who's helping us here in Cork until we appoint a new director. It's limited their ability to go out and have group masses and attend funerals and lots of other things. But it doesn't stop you from contacting them and say, listen, such and such is sick, or such a one has died. Will you contact them, or will you say prayers for them, or whatever? So don't be shy at lifting the phone and saying, Father Dan, I need you to go there, or Father Frank, will you send a mass card to such a one, whatever. So they're well able to work, so just give them plenty to do if they can't get out to you. And as I think of them, I'm thinking also of the staff in our offices, because they're really the front line of the Family Vocations community. So I want to thank Patricia and Janet in Drumantine, Helen and Kay in Dublin, Madge and Martina in Clare Galway, and Patricia here in Cork. For all the work that you do. And also I know Linda and Mairead help a lot down here in the south when we had meetings, and please God next year we'll probably, hopefully, please God, we'll have them again. So thank you to all who are involved in keeping this sponsoring movement going. We're in our 61st year, and please God we'll also see the 100, though some of us mightn't see it, but there'll be others here to take after us. So I conclude by saying thank you. And I pray that God may keep you, your families, your sponsors, all our supporters throughout the country, and also our missionaries and the communities that they are privileged to serve in Africa, that it will keep us all safe from this pandemic, and that we will be safe and come through it and be able to give thanks to God for his many blessings. The 7:15 Mass in Blackrock Road every morning is offered for all our sponsors, for all of you, living and deceased. So let us continue to pray for vocations, asking the Lord to call many more young men and young women to be missionaries, to be missionaries here at home and to be missionaries in foreign lands, but particularly for our own Society of African Missions and our OLA sisters. How lovely on the mountains are the feet of one who brings good news. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
We stand now together and pray the words that proclaim our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Gathered together as brothers and sisters in the SMA Family Vocations community, we praise God for his many blessings as we ask him to hear our prayers for our present needs. We pray for our world as we endure this coronavirus pandemic, and we pray that it will soon be over. Protect those doctors, nurses, health workers and volunteers who are on the front line of this emergency and who are risking their own lives to take care for others. Be with all who have been affected in any way by the pandemic and give them your healing. We pray for our church, the Pope, and all who have positions of leadership. Strengthen them during these difficult days and fill them with your Holy Spirit to enable them to guide us according to the truth of the Gospel. We pray for God's blessing on all the members of the Family Vocations communities and their families, the few who are with us today, and the many throughout the country who are joining us via the webcam. We praise you, Lord, for their continued support as they share our missionary work of spreading the gospel in Africa and around the world. We pray that more people will respond to God's invitation and offer themselves to labor in his harvest by bringing the good news to those who have not yet heard of Christ. May all of us support with our prayers those who do respond. Loving Father, grant eternal joy to our head sponsors and sponsors whom you have called to yourself. May their souls and the souls of all the faithful departed rest in your peace. We pray quietly now for our personal intentions. These are the prayers we offer you today, Lord God. We know that you hear them, and we ask you to grant them through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Every year at the FEC annual mass at the offertory, we have the presentation of symbolic gifts, gifts that symbolize the life and work of a missionary. The first gift, the first symbol, is the Bible, and we will have Margaret Ryan to hold the Bible for us. The Bible is the written record of God's Word. After 8 years of prayer and study, the newly ordained missionaries are ready to preach the good news of Jesus Christ to the people of Africa. Our second symbol is the African gown, or African art, will be held by John Ryan. The African gown symbolizes the color and vibrancy of Africa. The new missionaries spend the first year learning the language and customs of the people. Then they can speak the good news in a way that they can understand. Our third symbol will be held for us by Kathleen Crowley, is the crucifix. We preach a crucified and risen Lord. No glory without the cross, no crown without thorns. We all have a cross to carry. Let us unite our suffering with the sacrifice of Calvary. Our fourth symbol will be held by Marie Tully, is the candle. Jesus Christ is the light of the world. He brings light and hope into the dark corners of life we wish to hide. We receive this light at baptism, and we follow Christ on the true path that leads to eternal life. Our fifth symbol, Certificate of Remembrance, will be held by Patricia Nagel. This Mass is offered for all who helped our newly ordained on the road to the missionary priesthood. The 7:15 a.m. Mass each morning in Blackrock Road here in Cork is offered for our benefactors, living and deceased. We always remember our supporters in our prayers and Masses. And our final gifts will be held by Linda Harrington, the gifts of bread and wine. On the evening before he suffered, Jesus took bread and wine and gave us his own body and blood. we now carry out his command to do this in memory of me. We are all invited to share in his Holy Supper. Pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. O God, who gave us the gift of true prayer and of peace, graciously grant that through this offering we may do fitting homage to your divine majesty, and by partaking of the sacred mystery, we may be faithfully united in mind and heart through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in you we live and move and have our being. And while in this body we not only experience the daily effects of your care, but even now possess the pledge of life eternal. For having received the first fruits of the Spirit, through whom you raised up Jesus from the dead, we hope for an everlasting share in the Paschal mystery. And so, with all the angels we praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Fintan our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her husband, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen. Amen. We stand now and pray together to our Father as one family with the words Jesus gave us. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
And may the peace that only Jesus gives be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord,
I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Our spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come spiritually into my heart. I believe you are already here within me, and I unite myself wholly to your presence. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Thank you.
Deus meus ad uvae, toda na jarca vicinda, toda na jarca vicinda, Deus meus ad Domine, Domine, exaudi me, manum velon dit groier, manum velon dit groier. Domine, Domine, exaudi
Before our final prayer and final blessing, I will ask our provincial, Father Malachy Flanagan, to say a few closing words for us.
Good evening, everybody. And as provincial, I speak now on behalf of the SMA Irish province to you who are present here in the church and to you who are listening in and joining with us through the webcam to thank you as we have gathered for this special Thanksgiving Mass for the FEC for the generous and the wonderful support of each and every one of you have been given to the Family Vocations Community, the FEC, since its existence over 61 years ago. The FEC was founded so that you can play a part in the training of our SMA students to become SMA missionary priests. And we heard all about that from Father Martin in his homily today. And what a part you have played, marvelous indeed, because it is through your support, no doubt about it, your financial support and your prayerful support, that we have had hundreds and hundreds of SMA priests ordained over those past 61 years. And they continue that work of evangelization, preaching to the peoples of Africa and beyond. And not only that, but also it makes it possible for our priests to reach out and come to the aid of the poor and those who are most abandoned in those areas. I know this year of 2020 is a year we're not going to forget very easy. We have all been affected by this COVID-19. And it has made things very difficult for us. But I want you to know that we as SMAs, we hold you in our daily prayers and in our masses. And we trust that God will continue to watch over us and help us to see the end of this pandemic. The work of the SMA, the work of the FEC continues. Again, we heard today that there are over 350 students, SMA students, training in Africa, in Asia, Europe, and the USA. And they will become the SMA missionary priests of tomorrow. But we still depend on you and on your support and on your prayers. So please continue to help us with this work. And may God bless you and your families and reward you for your generosity. Thank you to all who helped to organize this beautiful Thanksgiving Mass today to to Father Pat Kelly for leading us in this Mass. Thanks to you, our sponsors, our supporters, our FSC directors, our FSC staff who are in our houses, and for the great work that you all do. Thanks again, and may God bless you all.
I am the light of the world, says the Lord. Whoever follows me will not walk in darkness, but will have the light of life. We stand for our final prayer. Let us pray. Grant that your faithful, O Lord, whom you nourish and endow with life, through the food of your word and heavenly sacrament, may so benefit from your beloved Son's great gifts, that we may merit an eternal share in his life, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Please bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. We thank God for the goodness and generosity of all the SMA sponsors, who through their missionary zeal have contributed so much by their missionary work over the past years. Amen. May the missionary work you have done and your prayers for vocations bear fruit in the continued growth of the Church in Africa and the spread of the gospel. Amen. May the Lord bless you and your families, protect you and guide you, fill you with faith and love, and assure you of his constant presence in your lives over the coming years. Amen. May the Lord hear your prayers, which you make from the bottom of your hearts. Bring consolation to those who have been bereaved. Ease the burdens which they carry, and draw them close to Christ your Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
I ask our concelebrants to join me in the final blessing, and may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit descend upon you and remain with you forever. Amen. Our Mass is ended. Let us go in the joy of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I dance in the morning when the world was begun. I danced in the moon and the stars and the sun. I came down from heaven and I danced on the earth. At Bethlehem I had my birth. Dance, dance, wherever you may be. I am the Lord of the dance, said he, and I lead you all wherever you may be. And I lead you all in the dance, said he. I danced for the scribes and the Pharisees. They would not dance, but they wouldn't follow me. I danced for the fishermen, for James and John. They came with me and the dance went on. Dance, dance, wherever you may be. I am the Lord of the dance, said he. And I lead you all wherever you may be. And I lead you all in the dance, said he. Dance, dance, wherever you may be. I am the Lord.
Good morning, brothers and sisters. Good morning, friends of the SMA. This is Father Ignatius Malwa. I know you know it's a familiar face. I have been in Ireland for 3 years working in Munster province as a director of the Family Vocations Community. I'm just back home in leadership after the change of leadership in the SMA in the year 2020. I had a great experience while in Ireland, and I have met over 80% of the members of the Family Vocations community in Munster, in Dromantine, in Leinster, in Dublin, and in Galway. And I had a great experience among you. And it was an enriching experience. And I'm back home, still missing the moments that we shared, the tea that we shared, and sometimes the mass that we celebrated in your homes, prayed for your families and prayed for your friends. It was so enriching for me. Just the presence among you, your generosity in your homes, your generosity towards the missions of the SMA and the missions of the church. We are living in difficult times, especially the times of COVID, and I know that most of you were affected. I pray especially for the SMA friends that may have lost their lives through the pandemic, that God our Father will bless them and grant them eternal life in his kingdom. And for all of you who may have been sick and are surviving the pandemic, I pray that God grants you health of mind and body. It was enriching for me being among you because I heard about the FVC when I was back here in Zambia, and when I came to Ireland and I was able to put names on the faces of the people that I met, it was very, very, very important for me. And throughout my training, the fathers who came from Ireland, they talked so much about the FVC. And for me, being among you and being in your presence just changed the concept of those people who were there, generous enough to support me in my training and support me also in my priesthood and on mission. Society of African Missions this year are ordaining 28 men to priesthood, and over 20 deacons will be ordained priests next year. And all these ordinations are possible even in these difficult times through the help of the Family Vocations community. We are so much appreciative, especially from the African communities, that you have supported us throughout our vocation, throughout our training to priesthood. We are over 170 SMA Africans ordained through the help of the FVC Family Vocations community. And you have gone out of your way to help us go through school, go through training, and now we are priests. And the only gift that we can offer to you are our prayers. In this time of COVID, I know that you cannot have masses in your homes. We cannot travel to your various places to celebrate mass with you and also to thank you for what you are doing for the mission. But we are always remembering you in our prayers. We are remembering you in our masses. We are so much conscious of everything that you are doing for our mission, especially your generosity towards us. I miss you. I miss the lovely times that we had together when we shared tea, when we shared the Eucharist in your homes and prayed for your families and friends. I miss those times, and I know that one day I'll come back and share the same events with you in the near future when the pandemic calms down. Thank you very much for your great help. Thank you very much for what you are doing for the SMA. Thank you very much for what you are doing for the mission of God. May God bless all your generosity through Christ our Lord. Amen.